Welcome to my channel, where cringy intros are cringy.
Yes, hello today. Look, we have Let's Go Legends. This is the new event for basically all players. You get to pick which team you want to essentially farm, and you get one Star Dash token to use it on. Now, you might be wondering, how do I play this event? Especially if I'm a new player, like how do I even begin to play the event? Why will it not let me play it? Well, it's because you didn't read. So let's actually go to the missions, because that's where it wants you to go. So if you click on the missions, not there though, these missions, sorry guys, menu, missions, and then we go to special. You're going to see here we have Star Dash Mission Saiyan, Star Dash Mission Missions Lineage of Evil, and Star Dash Mission Sagas from the movies. Personally speaking, if I were to pick any of these three to actually start off a team, I personally think that the most relevant, and of course this is pending to any changes in the future, but personally speaking, out of these three, the one with the most value would be the Saiyans. Originally, I thought it would have been Lineage of Evil. However, Lineage of Evil isn't exactly what I would say top tier right now. It's not bad. It's just that it is very much underperforming in the meta, whereas Saiyans is thriving. Now, Super Saiyan 3 Pure Goku isn't exactly what I would say the most common pick for purples in Saiyans, but he's definitely a solid pick and a one of the core options that you can choose from. So as a result, if you are interested in Saiyans and you eventually want to get his Zenkai, then they will give him to you to 7 stars pretty much by picking that. So how do you unlock it? So actually, let me just unlock it now with you guys so you guys get to see that. So personally speaking myself, I don't actually need the purple Goku or any of the units there, so I'm not going to pick that one. But for those of you that are new, that are interested in Saiyans particularly, go for the Star Dash Mission Saiyans. If you like Space Monkeys, aka Lineage of Evil, then I would say go for the Cooler, go for the Frieza. That's also a fair pick, because Cooler does get a Zenkai, and that's nice. However, I specifically am going to be picking Movies. It's not because it's the best units. No. It's because I want to 14-star my Broly that I own. I also want a 14-star my Gohan that I own. And the only way for me to really do that is to, you know, well, pick these. So we're going to pick them. And that's the only reason why I'm doing it. I personally believe this is not the one to go for. The only actual good unit in this mission start dash for Sagas from the Movies is the Broly. And he's usually only a bench unit. Whereas on Lineage of Evil, Cooler is a meta pick. And then on the Saiyans, the Goku is a core option on Saiyans as well. So you have two actual core options from just these start missions. Whereas Sagas, you have nothing. So yeah, there you go. So let's pick this because that's the one I want. We're going to unlock it. Yep. So there we go. And then as you can see, based upon what you've done within that mission, you will get a certain amount of stuff completed. All you have to do, essentially, is play the event as well as do some other things. So as you can see, a lot of it is like clear Let's Go Legends Battle 6, raise Super Saiyan Broly to level 3000, raise him to 5000, raise him to godly class, so soul boosting, battling in the events. So clear Let's Go Legends Battle 7. Make sure to actually clear that battle. Don't just dabble. Clear it completely, please. As you can see, it's just a whole bunch of stuff. So we're going to go over all of this. So what does it mean to form a party? Well, let's actually take a look right now and see what we can do. So let's form a party right now, okay? So we are going to form a party with Bojack. So to do that, what I'm going to do is I am going to find Bojack, which at some point I'll find him. There we go. We're going to do that. And then what we're going to do is we're going to do that. And we're going to put in Janemba. There we go. This guy, just because I can. Let's see. Where is the green movies Goku? Him as well, because why not? And then, I don't remember what was the last unit they gave us, so I think what I'm going to do, just to put some filler in here, is I'm just going to pick any random unit. So let's just... Oh, wait, that's one. That's the one that they told us to pick. So let's see if that worked. I think it did work. Yep, see, and there you go. Now we have formed a party with those units. And as you can see, it completed some more things. Now it's asking me to battle using X units 3 times. So there you go. It's then saying to battle with those units 5 times. And then once you've done that, you are done completely. So that's all there is to this event. It's pretty simple. And it essentially allows you to just farm up them units and make them stronger. So there you go. Overall, not a bad event. And it's interesting. It's not too hard either. As you can see, I have cleared it all. If you are struggling to beat these, I'm going to list in the description down below, as well as in the pinned comment, an advanced guide to how to beat the AI, so that way you guys can play against them and beat them using the drift method. If you find this easy, though, then you don't have to bother. But with that being said, just make sure that you are actually watching the link that I posted down below. So that way, in case that these final 3 battles are too hard, well, you'll not find it too hard because you'll, you know, win because you'll use the drift method. So there you have it. So with that being said, guys, that's the video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please don't hesitate to tickle the like button if you haven't already subscribed. And click at the bell for more notifications so you never miss another one of my videos. Have yourselves a salty day. And I will see you in the next video.
Thanks for stopping by. Hope you had a time, Phil G.
Phil G.